Blackstone Audiobooks presents
Daniel Boone, Wilderness Scout by Stewart Edward White. Chapter 1. When we think of American pioneers, we recall automatically certain names: Daniel Boone, Davy Crockett, Kit Carson, perhaps Simon Kenton. Of course, there were hundreds, yes, thousands of others who met the same dangers, exhibited at least approximate skill, fought the same savages. But the names of most of them are unknown, and of the rest only the especial student is aware. Often the more obscure men have performed specific deeds that common legend ascribes to better-known names. Columbus, as we know, was really not the first to discover America. Common belief has it that Daniel Boone discovered Kentucky, but actually, as we shall see, he first entered Kentucky lured by the glowing tales of a man named Finley, who had, with others, preceded him. Did you ever hear of Finley? But we have all heard of Daniel Boone. This is because these men have possessed some quality that the others did not. It did not matter what especial deeds they performed. Others must have performed similar feats, or the West would never have been conquered. Those deeds became renowned, not so much because they were thrilling, but because of the men who did them. Thus, Daniel Boone's name is inseparably connected with the occupation of the dark and bloody ground, because he was Daniel Boone. He was one of the many great Indian fighters of his time, lived for years with his rifle and tomahawk next his hand, lost brothers and sons under the scalping knife. He was a master of woodcraft, able to find his way hundreds of miles through unbroken forests, able to maintain himself alone not merely for a day or a week, but for a year or more without other resources than his rifle, his tomahawk, and his knife, and this in the face of the most wily of foes. He was muscular and strong and enduring, victor in many a hand-to-hand combat, conqueror of farms cut from the forest, performer of long journeys afoot, at speed that would seem incredible to a college athlete. He was a dead shot with the rifle, an expert hunter of game. Other men long since forgotten were all these things. But Daniel Boone was reverent in the belief that he was ordained by God to open the wilderness. He was brave, with a courage remarkable for its calmness and serenity. Calmness and serenity, indeed, seemed to have been his characteristics in all his human relations. Those who knew him remark frequently on this, speak of the fact that where everyone else was an Indian hater, Boone never cherished rancor against them, so that as honorable antagonists they always met, both in peace and war. He was trustworthy, so that when wilderness missions of great responsibility were undertaken, he was almost invariably the one called. He was loyal to the last drop of his blood, as you shall see in this narrative. He was ready ever to help others. These are simple, fundamental qualities, but they are never anywhere too common. They are rarely anywhere combined in one man, and in those rough times of primitive men they sufficed, when added to his wilderness skill and determination, to make him the leading and most romantic figure. If the Boy Scouts would know a man who, in his attitude toward the life to which he was called, most nearly embodied the precepts of their laws, let them look on Daniel Boone. Gentle, kindly, modest, peace-loving, absolutely fearless, a master of Indian warfare, a mighty hunter, strong as a bear and active as a panther. His life was lived in daily danger, almost perpetual hardship and exposure, yet he died in his bed at nearly 90 years of age. Chapter 2. Any normal and healthy boy would have reveled in a youth similar to that of Daniel Boone. He was the fourth of seven brothers, and was born on the banks of the Delaware River about 20 miles above Philadelphia. His place in history can be better remembered than by dates, when you know that he was just 3 years younger than George Washington. When he was 3 years old, the family moved upstate to a frontier settlement that has since become the city of Reading. Here he spent his boyhood and his early youth, and here he took his first lessons in a school that was to help him through all his life, the wilderness. For at that time, Reading was...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.